أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم والتابعين إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم ارزقنا علما نافعا ورزقا واسعا وشفاء من كل داء، ونعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع ومن قلب لا يخشع ومن عين لا تدمع ومن نفس لا تشبع ومن دعاء لا يستجاب له. آمين آمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم ألهمنا وسددنا، اللهم ألهمنا رشدنا وقنا شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. يا حي يا قيوم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، برحمتك نستغيث. اللهم اصلح لنا شأننا كله، ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين، وارض عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا وكن معنا ولا تكن علينا. انظر إلينا وأنت راض عنا، ولا تنظر إلينا وأنت غضبان علينا يا رب العالمين. اكرمنا ولا تهنا، زدنا ولا تنقصنا، اهدنا يا ربي وعافنا واعف عنا، وارزق نفوسنا تقواها، وزكها أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها، بفضلك وجودك وكرمك وإحسانك يا رب العالمين. أعزنا بالإسلام، وأعز الإسلام بنا، وأعز الإسلام والمسلمين، وأعلي بحقك كلمة الحق والدين، واجعلنا من الهداة المهديين، غير ضالين أو مضلين، أو فاتنين أو مفتونين، أو مبدلين أو مبتدعين، بفضلك وجودك وكرمك وإحسانك يا رب العالمين. عاملنا بما أنت أهله، ولا تعاملنا بما نحن أهله، فأنت أهل الجود والكرم والإحسان. اللهم يا ربي اشفي مرضى المسلمين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها، واغفر وارحم لموتى المسلمين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها، وارحمنا إذا سرنا إلى ما ساروا إليه يا رب العالمين. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: بادروا بالأعمال سبعا. Hurry up with seven action. Hurry up with seven action. ما تنتظرون إلا فقرا منسيا. Except you waiting for what? Poverty? Poverty make you forgotten. أو غنى مضغيا. Or money and status, it make you oppressor. أو مرضا مفسدا. Or a disease or illness, it make you lose your time and your life. أو هرما مفندا. Or aging, it make you useless and it make you weak. أو موتا مجهزا. Or a death is ready for you. أو الدجال. المسيح الدجال. فإنه شر غائب. This is so unseen, you do not remember. كلمتي. منتظر is coming. أو الساعة. Or the day of judgment. والساعة أدهى وأمر. Or the day of judgment. And the day of judgment is more severe. This is a tough one. And this hadith, رواه الترمذي. حديث حسن إن شاء الله. When you look at this advice, this is what we're living. Either poverty. Poverty make you always running after something to eat or something to do and make you forget who you are and what you're living for. Or money. Too much money. And dunya, 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 dunya. To the point, you have no time. and make you arrogant and ego and selfish and greedy and destroy you. Or a disease. Once you have a disease, an illness, your ability is less. The ability to do good deed, the ability to worship, the ability of anything is gone. Finished. Or age. Look at the elder people. The body is ache. They cannot sleep well. They cannot do anything. Their life becomes useless. This is why one of the dua of Rasulullah ﷺ, and don't make me live ila arda lil umr. Don't make me live until late age, which today in Europe and America and all this Western society, they said, oh, today we're living in a beautiful state. Why? Because the life expectancy increased compared to the past. And you go to the hospital, go to the nursing home. Now every hospital in the United States and Europe, you find one floor. Whole floor full of people. What these people? With chronic disease. 10 years, 15 years, 20 years in bed. Poor human being. In the paper, oh, he lived until the age 200. They pass 105. They pass 103. Whatever. They pass 16. But you look for the last 25 years or 30 years. What are you doing? Years! Is he lying down, aching or under drugs? I never forget it. I never forget it. Somebody asked me to meet this man, to go visit him in the hospital. I forget his name. He's one of the multi-millionaire or billionaire during this time. During this time as well, I was young. I was in like late 20, maybe early 30. You know what he's looking for? He's looking at me and tell me, son, I like your talk, but I have a question for you. I forget how many buildings he has in Manhattan, New York. Every building like 10, 15 million, 20 million. And he has like 50, 60 of them. He tell me, can I give you 50% of my property? After that, he was quiet. He said, no. I give you 80% of my property. After that, he tell me, no. I give you all my capital. I forget how many million or billion. And he tell me, but can you give me your age? Can you give me your two leg? I wish to walk. I cannot walk. I miss walking. Do you know how long I've been in a bed? I forget, he tell me like 10, 12 years. He said, imagine, I have all this money and you cannot give me legs. I have this money and I cannot walk. I have this money, I cannot eat. I have this money, I cannot enjoy anything. I left his room crying, thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By this way, how many people super rich and their life is agony? Agony. Or living or sleeping in a bed. Even to move somebody, two nurse or somebody has to come to move them. What about how many hundred and thousand of elder all over? Even Japan and a Scandinavian country and America and Europe, when the kids abandoned their parents and put them in a nursing home and they live lonely. They live very lonely. Very lonely and very weak. Very lonely and very weak. By this way, lonely, weak, useless, restless, good for nothing. And even subhanAllah, A lot of these people, they cannot even start spending. They cannot. And they leave a big wealth. Either some of the kids will take it, or the government will take it, or somebody will steal it from them. Poor human being, living all his life to accumulate, and he will be punished with it. And no benefit for himself, and no benefit to mankind. Imagine over one third of the population under poverty line. One third of the population, meaning over 1.5 billion human beings, have almost something to eat, just a piece of bread. And you have less than 2-3% of the population controlling the wealth of mankind. And you will not release it. And they champion each other. So-and-so multimillionaire, so-and-so multi-billionaire, and people die. And now, among us, among all Muslim, you have people like that. And they watching and they hearing the calamity. Thank Allah, you do not have all this money. Because money and status come with responsibility. And if you do not feel the responsibility, you are in big trouble. If you're living in a room and you have nothing, thank Allah. Allah love you. There's many a hadith about when Rasulullah said, if Allah love a servant, he guard him from dunya. He guard him from dunya. Like the mother guarding her own son of harm and fire. First of all, if you see Allah did not give you too much, thank Allah. Even visibility. How many mean even a Muslim leader or somebody have visibility? After that, they become arrogant and ego, and they lost their goodness inside. Thank Allah all the time. Allah is wise. He do taqdeer to everything. Thank Allah for the status quo. The only thing you do not thank Allah for, your struggle. Don't thank Allah for your struggle, but beg Allah to give you more ability to struggle. Beg Allah to open the door of goodness. Beg Allah, be hungry to be good. أو موتا مجهزا, a preparing death, because death is already prepared for me and you. It's already dead, it's already planned, it's already everything ordained, and we're just walking toward our death, but we do not know when. أو الدجال, the one eye. And I believe we are in the time of Dajjal. And why Allah call him Dajjal? Dajjal meaning the one who deceive. He deceive. The truth, it look false. And the false, it look truth. And this is what we're living for now, or at now. Everybody looking for dunya. And we forget akhirah. Argue with each other, worry about this, worry about that. It's false. What we worry about, we should not worry about. And what we should worry about, we not worry about. And this a calamity is absence. Is absence. What it meaning? Ghaib. We cannot see it. And when you cannot see something, you can forget it. And if you forget it, there is a problem, but it's coming. No doubt about it. Or Sa'a, the Day of Judgment, and this is the ultimate calamity. There's many a hadith about this topic, And one of them, when the Ummah forgetting Dajjal, meaning Dajjal is coming. But let me take you to another hadith and after that try to join both of them. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه again أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال بادروا بالأعمال فتنا كقطع الليل المظلم. هاي of doing because the fitna will coming like the broken pieces of darkness. What it meaning? Meaning the fitna will be like rolling one after another, one after another, one after another. And this fitna, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam compared to what? To the pieces of darkness. One of the explanation, if you are in a dark room and I keep showing you a pieces of something dark, can you distinguish? Imagine a very dark room, dark, 100% dark. And I have sheets of dark clothing. I tell you, look, I can have 10 sheets, keep rotating. It will make a difference for you? No, you cannot see it. You cannot distinguish the difference. By this way, darkness over darkness, darkness inside darkness. What it meaning? You cannot distinguish. And if you ask me today, we are in it. We are in it and we do not feel it. Family, this, job, that, husband, kids, money, status, this, that. And we do not see it as a fitna. We do not see it. By this way, actually, if I meet you and ask you, what's the problem? Oh, husband, this, that, money, this, that, job. And she tell me, and he tell me, what are that, are that? And before you know it, no any sentence about what you should worry about. Do you worry about meeting Allah? No. Do you worry about the status of Iman? No. Do you think and you have certain feeling for Allah? No. Are you thinking about your death? No. Are you thinking about who will pray over you when you die? No. Do you think where are you going to die? No. Imagine. Do you know the status in the moment of death? No. Do you know if the Dajjal coming, can you fight it? Believe it or not, if the Dajjal coming today, maybe 99% of us will be a follower of him. Because it will be a lot of drought before that, meaning hunger. And he has two hands. In one hand is Jannah. One hand is hellfire. This is what he said. And Jannah is hellfire, hellfire is Jannah. It's the opposite. And between, actually he has one eye, but in his forehead is a kafir sign. But let me give you bad news. Only the believer will see the sign. وَلَيَذُ بِاللَّهِ if I'm a hypocrite or is not written for me, I will not see it. And he said, I'm your Lord, أنا Allah. And a lot of people will follow him. Actually, the majority of the people of the earth will follow him. Why? Because they want to eat. And if you disobey him, he will kill you. And according to him, he put you in hellfire. But meaning you're going to Jannah. And again, the majority of people will follow him. The majority of people will obey him. If you ask me, what's the difference? Today, what we obey the Dajjal of time. Not the physical Dajjal, but we obey ourselves. We obey our nafs. We obey husband and wife. We obey kids. We obey this. We worry about this. We worry about money. We worry about provision. We worry about this. And we not worry at all about what we should worry about. And after that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what he said, يُصْبِحُ الرَّجْلُ مُؤْمِنًا. The person, the man, meaning the human being, will wake up a mu'min. وَيُمْسِي كَافِرًا. And he will sleep a kafir. Or maybe, يُمْسِي مُؤْمِنًا. He will sleep a mu'min. And وَيُصْبِحْ كَافِرًا. And he wake up a kafir. What it meaning? The condition of the heart keep changing very fast. Today I wake up, I have iman. A calamity happened or a situation or whatever. And all of a sudden I lose my iman and all I'm thinking about is the situation. Finished. I lost my iman. Or I wake up a mu'min. Or the opposite. I wake up a kafir. And later on, Allah give me guidance, I become a mu'min. What it mean? A warning. A warning of the fast changing in the state of the heart. What it mean? The iman is so weak. And the calamity and fitna is so severe. We losing our deen. Today we lose it for a job, for money, for a husband again, or a wife, or a kids, or a status. Dunya. Dunya. Why? The loyalty and the reality of journey of iman is not there. Some ritual, some basic iman, and when a piece of dunya come, we're ready to drop our iman. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he ended up the hadith, يَبِيعَ دُونَهُ بَعَرَضٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. He sell his own deen with little bit of dunya. He sell his deen with little bit of dunya. We willing to do it. And this in Sahih Muslim. Narrated in Sahih Muslim. Meaning all what I'm telling you, authentic ahadi, authentic report. And we in it. And we live in it. Why? Because the love of dunya make us blind. Blind of what? Blind from akhirah. To the point today, we acting like when you go to somebody and you talk to them and the person tell you, no, I don't want to hear. I don't want to hear. I cannot see you. I don't want to see you. But we're doing the same thing, but for something higher, akhirah. We're so exhausted and drowning in dunya, we cannot see akhirah. We cannot. And this is scary. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah An-Nazi'at, chapter An-Nazi'at, verse 37-41. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said? فَأَمَّا مَنْ طَغَى those who do tughyan, oppress, وَآثَرَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا and prefer his dunya, فَإِنَّ الْجَحِيمَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. The hellfire, it is his resident. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ and whoever fear the status of his Lord, وَنَحَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى and capture his nafs from his desire, فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. Jannah is his place and his resident. Very simple. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Really. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Somebody send me an email containing one sheikh talk. Very famous, believe it or not. I would not mention his name. And He has a verse from Quran. And this verse, verse 14, Ali Imran. And this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he talk about زُيِّنَ لِلنَّاسَ حُبِّ الشَّهْوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ وَالْبَنِينَ. The dunya and the love of desire and women and kids, it is like decorated to mankind, to the people. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the end, he said, this is the joy of dunya, and Allah, he has the best. He took that and he keep emphasizing about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He want us and he create us with loving dunya. By the way, may Allah forgive me. Today, we really drowning in dunya. Drowning in dunya big time. When you read the life of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the companion and all messenger prophet compared to us, huge difference. We have knowledge. We have Quran, we have Hadith, we believe in Allah, we believe in Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we believe in the Day of Judgment, but our action is the opposite completely. This topic, I can talk about it for a long time. But one of the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is dua. Allahumma inni as'aluka fi'la al-khayrat. O Allah, I ask you to do good deed. Wa tarka al-munkarat. And to leave the bad action. Wa hubbu al-masakeen. And love the masakeen, the poor people and the broken-hearted one, the one closer to you. Wa an taghfir li wa tarhamni. And forgive me, Allah, and give me rahmah. وَإِذَا أَرَدْتَ فِتْنَةً فِي قَوْمٍ. And if you descended fitna in any place, فَتَوَفَّنِي غَيْرَ مَفْتُونَ. Take my soul before I become a part of the fitna. وَأَسْأَلُكَ حُبَّكَ. And I ask you, Ya Allah, your love. وَحُبِّ مَنْ يُحِبَّكَ. And the love of those who love you. وحب كل عمل يقربني إلى حبك. And to love every action beloved to you and make me closer to you. Ameen, ameen ya Rabb al-Alamin. This is a principle. This is a principle. I always make it to myself. Oh Allah, make me live if my life is good for me. And take me, Allah, if my death is good for me. And if you descended fitna to the earth, then make me a part of it. And take my soul before that. Is allowed. This is allowed. This is allowed. And actually recommended in a time of fitna. Because saving your iman above anything else. Today, when we meet each other, how are you? How is your daughter? How is your son? How is the job? How is the car? How is the house? How is the dog? How is the cat? How is this? How is that? Imagine, we worry about everything. But how is Iman? How is Akhirah? How is your day? How is your good deed? How is your habit? How is your manner? How is your connection? What you have in your heart, what you want to achieve. Imagine all this not important. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. That's why we flip the situation of a mu'min. What we worry about it, we should not worry about it. And what we should worry about it, we not worry about it. Ya Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Alaq, verse 6 and 7, كَلَّا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى أَن رَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى. Allah explained that insan, mankind, when Allah give them yadgha, he become oppressor. أَن رَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى. And that's it. He's not concerned. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in Sahih al-Bukhari, actually I'm sorry, the seven scholar narrated this hadith. When Rasulullah sallam, he said, لن تقوم الساعة, the Day of Judgment will not get started until the 10th sign. And the 10th sign, the sun will rise from the west. And the animal will come. An animal, almost like a cow, but it's not a cow. And will talk to people. Will come. And Ya'juj and Ma'juj, this creature called Ma'juj and Ma'juj, will get up and spread mischief in earth and killing big time. What Dajjal? Al-Masih al-Dajjal, the creature with one eye, the one who claimed he's our Lord. وعيسى بن مريم, Jesus, peace be upon him. والدخان, and the smoke or the fire. وثلاثة خسوف, and major, okay, like earthquake. One from the west, one from the east, and one in the Arabic Peninsula. And the end will be a fire, will coming from Yemen. It will start from Yemen. It will generate massive fire. It makes the people run to the place where the Day of Judgment will start. All the majority of scholars agree we are on the edge of the 10th sign. We are on the edge of the 10th sign, meaning we're very close. When? We do not know. Now, we talk about that. We know about that. We hear about that. But what happened? Again, our dunya so overwhelming, it masks us, it veil us from remember the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hajj, verse 1, he said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسَ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. O you people, fear your Lord. The shaking and the horrible sound of the Day of Judgment is very severe. Read the beginning of Surah Al-Hajj, you will know. Just verse 1 to 3. It's very straightforward. عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن عائشة رضي الله عنها. He said, whoever Allah make him stand and he talk to him, meaning he questioning him, he will go to Jahannam. Meaning if you reach the level, Allah will question what going on with you, you finished. You finished. If you read about this topic, it's big. I always say what is the status of your heart? What is the status of your thinking? What is the status, I'm sorry, what is the status of your desire? A mu'min should be between worry, scare, hope, love, desire to meet his Lord. And if this is the case, his love, his devotion, his feeling, his time, his money, his ability, driven to please his Lord. And especially at this time, either we be in a state of developing ourselves or warning and spread the da'wah to other, or to care about the needy and orphan. Meaning you should be in a stage of really worry about the condition of mankind and the ummah. Because this is our duty. This is our responsibility. This is our duty. This is our responsibility. Because when you meet Allah, what are you going to tell him? I don't care. I was so good. I fasting, I read Quran, I do this, but I don't care about mankind. I don't care about my people. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said it, مَنْ لَمْ يَهْتَمَّ بَأَمْرَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَلَيْسَ مِنَّا. Whoever do not care about the condition of the ummah, he's not among us. Straightforward. You cannot be passive. You cannot be greedy and selfish and worry about yourself only. This why my message is not like a personal message. It is the message to save our neck from the responsibility in the front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the responsibility is big. The amana is big. And how I can meet you if I didn't do anything for you? Imagine. You tell me, come here. You have a meeting with me. Imagine if you give me a homework. And I know I need you. I need certain thing from you. How I can meet you when I didn't do anything? Or I do too little. And I abuse all the bounty you give me. What will happen now? What will happen? How I meet you? This why the mu'min, he loved to meet his Lord. And the kafir al-munafiq, he hate death. Because if I'm a mu'min, inshallah, I hope, I know what I'm trying to do, I cannot wait to see Allah and meet Allah. But if I'm a hypocrite, while I'm a disbeliever, you go and talk about death, don't worry. It's almost like if you don't talk about it, it will not happen. It will not happen. And people so worry about dying. And they forget, it is a reality. You will have to test it. You like it or you don't. Young and old. But we do not know when. Subhanallah. 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 Increase dhikrullah. Increase hadimul ladhat. Increase the destroyer of all the pleasure. They said, Ya Rasulullah, what is the destroyer of all the pleasure? He said, death. Death. Al-mawt. This is the topic today. We talk, we finish, and we go back to dunya. We talk, we finish, and we go back to dunya. This is scary. We should always worry about today. Only today. Only today. This is why you always make dua, oh Allah, give me the best of today. Give me the goodness of today. And protect me of the badness of today. And protect me from the worst of coming tomorrow. That's it. No week, no 1 month. Today. 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 Ya Allah. Ya Allah. Ya Allah. When you wake up, what we say, supposed to say, Alhamdulillah, الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا وإليه النشور. Alhamdulillah, the one who gave me life after death. And toward him, I will meet him. And there is the difference between us and the companion. Is he really a believer of meeting the Lord? And we're still far away from this feeling. If we get this feeling maybe once a year, we're lucky. And if did that happen, meaning the heart in a state of heedlessness, even if I'm reciting Quran, I pray. Because the reciting and Quran and praying is what? A reminder. You're getting closer. Do whatever you can now. Because what you're doing for Sabilillah is the only one will come in your baggage. That's why when you're ready, you're coming and the baggage or the bag or your luggage full of the good deed, insha'Allah, and your iman. But what about any money in the bank or any property? It will not benefit you. It's too late. You will wish you spend it before you die. You will wish you spend it before you die. And this is why my advice to you and to me first, read about the sign of the Day of Judgment. Read about the end of time. I tell you many times by Ibn Kathir. Read about the journey of soul after death. There's many books about it. It will make this dunya, this life become insignificant. Nothing. Nothing. And if you discover this dunya is nothing, you will not worry about all the condition and all the activity happen daily. Because all this drama will happen anyway. It's part of your destiny to trial you. But if you stand firm, if you belong to Allah, if you're really living the message, Allah will take care about you, sooner or later. Win the victory. The victory comes when you gain the victory within. When you gain the victory, then the victory from outside is coming. When you capture your nafs. And again, you know, a man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He told me, teach me something from Quran, something very powerful, but very small. He told him the best of the Quran. You know what it's one? قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. The two قُلْ is very powerful and make you close to Allah and make you beloved to Allah, protect you from shayateen, protect you from your nafs, protect you from eyes, protect you from the evil of the eyes and the eye of the evil. Protection. How many times we talk about it? Ayat al-Kursi, Surah al-Fatiha, the three Qul. But seeing it with your heart, seeing it with comprehending the meaning, seeing it and live it, it makes you so powerful. It makes you protect it. And if you protect it, now your thought is clear. Your vision is clear. Now you belong to Allah. And now your ability will be for Sabilillah. But if I'm not protected, Shaitan will attack me. Waswasa will attack me. I'm losing my time. I'm losing my strength. I'm losing my thought. I'm losing my feeling. And before I know it, I'm wasting my time. And I become fatigued and doing nothing. Good for nothing. And we have the tools. We have the weapon. Surah Al-Fatiha, Ayat Al-Kursi, the two Qul. And you add to them the third one, Qul Huwallahu Ahad. Go read about what Rasulullah said about the last two Qul. How many people complain about shayateen and attack? Keep saying Qul A'udhu Rabbi Al-Falaq, Qul A'udhu Rabbi Al-Nas. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he go to bed, what he do? He make wudu, he sit in the bed, he put his hand, and he do like that, tanafus. But tanfith meaning like this, without spitting. And he satisfied the threes. And he touched his body completely the maximum he can. With the intention of what? Protection. Imagine Rasulullah need protection. What about me and you? By this way, all this talk, it need protection. We need protection. We need the adhkar al-sabah wal-masa'. We need the protection of the day, protection of night. Protection of coming, protection of leaving, protection of entering. The more I'm living this protection, I'm protecting myself. I'm guarding myself. Now I can come over my weakness. I can come over my shayateen. I can come over the waswasa. And now I have the angel companion. And now my heart is more clean, with more tranquility. My thought is more clear. My vision is more clear. And now my body is more strong. My ability of my nafs to do good deeds is much easy. Now, can I take the medication on your behalf? No. Can you give it to me? No. Each one has to take the medication by himself. And this part of your journey. If you take the medication on time, like a clock, what will happen? Very soon you will be protected, guarded. And now you have your body getting stronger, your faith getting stronger, your vision getting stronger, your thought getting stronger, your heart getting stronger. And now your good deed gets stronger. And now you're getting closer to Allah. Now you have more protection from Allah. Now you have more angels. And now you have light surrounding you. Now you be well protected. And now you can achieve insha'Allah. It's not a talk. It's not just understanding and that said, no. If I listen, I comprehend, I understand, now what I have to do? I have to live it. I have to develop my strength, protect myself from all the disease, clean my heart from the disease of the heart, protect myself and my surrounding, make sure all the time in the right environment. Spend my day with zikrullah and tilawat al-Quran. And get closer to Allah with every good deed possible. I hurry to support people. I hurry to help people. I hurry to visit the sick. I am hurry to do whatever I can before the seven. And the seven is coming. Because dunya will never be forever. Today we can, tomorrow we cannot. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the blessing of our time, the blessing of our health, the blessing of our money. And O Allah, make our thought, our desire, and our love, and our body, and our money for you, Ya Allah. For you only, Allah, to please you, Allah. And give us sincerity and ikhlas and tawfiq and qabool and sidq in everything we say and we do. Give us the wisdom, Ya Allah, and basira to see the truth and follow it and see the wrong and evil and get away from it. And O Allah, we cannot be protected without your will, Ya Allah. Help us, Ya Allah. Help us to protect ourselves from our nafs, from shayateen, Ya Allah. Help us to protect ourselves from the evil of mankind and jinn, Ya Allah. O Allah, make us, Ya Allah, a keys of goodness, a lack of evils, and make us blessed. And give us blessing at whatever we go in our action, in our body, in our word, and give us nur and barakah and qabool in everything we say and we do, Ya Allah. And O Allah, don't take our soul, Ya Allah, until you please with us. And make us among those who are pleasing you and you pleasing them. And take us with the pleasure of you, Ya Allah. And make us busy only for one thing, for loving you. And loving your Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And love the believer. And love those who love you. And make others love you, Ya Allah. O Allah, we weak and you're strong. We poor and you're rich. We have no ability. We have no ability. We have no means. And you are the owner of all the ability and means. Open for us, Ya Allah. Open for us, Ya Allah. Open for us and the whole ummah. And you see the mischief all over. And you see the calamity of all over. And you see the aggression and oppression all over. And you see the killing all over. And you are al-Hakim, Ya Allah. Send your rahmah, Ya Allah. Send your guidance, Ya Allah. And make us among those who listen and watch and ache and try to do whatever we can, Ya Allah. Allah, Allah, and don't make this message witness against me, Ya Allah. Make this message witness to me, Ya Allah. Make the earth witness to me, Ya Allah, and don't make it witness against me, Ya Allah. Make all the bounty you give me a source to pleasing you, Ya Allah. O Allah, put barakah in all of us, Ya Allah. O Allah, you see the condition of the ummah, Ya Allah. Help us, Ya Allah. Help us to wake up the ummah, Ya Allah, before we die, Ya Allah. Ameen, ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ahli wa sahbihi ajma'in. Subhanaka Rabbil Izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al-mursalin. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Jazakumullahu kullu khair. Wa salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.